Well, police say one man has been duping some central Iowa businesses out of thousands of dollars in cash. The suspect's in jail now, but our Emily Price shows us the trail he left behind. Emily?
Yeah, Kevin, this is Matthew Hessel, the man police say showed up at stores with sob stories, but walked away a happy man.
He called us on Friday morning real early and said, I have a tree service company and I've had multiple saws and equipment stolen from me. And in turn, I asked if we would have plenty on hand and what we might have available.
Clive Power Equipment had plenty, and Matthew Hessel was there within the hour, snatching up six expensive steel saws.
He went into the much larger saws too, with the bought all four of these bottom ones, which happens to be our top of the line saws.
The bill came to more than $4,300, and Hessel paid with this check. He was back again on Monday, spending another $1,800. Problem was, the account was closed.
A lot of emotion kicks in right at that time. A lot of anger, of course.
When I talked to him, he actually admitted that it was an old account of his.
Live Detective Dan Anderson ended up tracking down Hessel at the Polk County Courthouse, where he was appearing before a judge on a different theft charge. Turns out Hessel's been in and out of court for theft and bad driving the past 15 years. This is his rap sheet, at least 90 charges long. Marsha's Jewelry in East Des Moines says he walked in and bought a $4,796 diamond ring in April with a bad check. Acme Tools on the South Side says he used two bad checks to buy $6,400 worth of tools the same month. This year alone, he's facing forgery or theft charges in six Iowa counties.
Police say Deary Brothers Chevrolet in Pleasant Hill is where Hessel got really bold. They say he wrote a $30,000 bad check here and drove away with the Chevy Avalanche. Deary Brothers didn't want to talk to us on camera about the alleged theft, but they say Hessel's girlfriend helped them get that truck back.
And he continues to get away with the same thing over and over and over, and I feel that's very unacceptable. When does our system stop something like this?
Detective Anderson says the second and third degree theft charges haven't been steep enough to keep him in jail for long.
The bond amount for that is only $5,000, so he could go through a bondsman. If he has $500 and a bondsman's willing to work with them, he can get out and has a court date later on, can go out and do the same thing.
People at Clive Power hope it doesn't happen to anyone else. They're out more than $6,000 because they wanted to help a man they thought was in a bind.
He really knew what he was talking about and really knew how to engage you in a way that connected you with him.
And tonight, Hessel remains in the Polk County Jail. The current charges that he's being held on are from Polk, Wayne, and Story counties.
Emily, this is just incredible. You mentioned his rap sheet's got 90 particular offenses on it, but in regards to these most latest ones, do they know what he was doing with all this equipment that he was, in effect, stealing?
Well, police believe he was pawning it for cash.
Wow. All right. Emily, thank you very much.
Sure.